Hello guys, my name is Asish and welcome to the XAdmin channel. I have started a new series of spring interview questions and answer series. In this series, I will cover all the important and the top interview questions in a spring asked by the interviewers in detail. I am making this spring interview question series to help you to prepare for the interviews and quickly revise the concept in general. I will strongly suggest you to go deeper into the each concept if you have extra time. The more you know, the more you will get confident in a interview session. So guys, this is the part first of this series. In this part, I will discuss total 25 important interview questions related to spring. Okay, and the more interview questions will be discussed later on the upcoming part. So guys, stay connected and please subscribe the channel if you have not subscribed yet. So guys, I will suggest you to watch this lecture till the end. So guys, start the session of a spring interview questions and answer part first. So guys, the first question you may get, like, what is a spring framework? Spring framework is a lightweight framework. It can be thought of a framework because it provides support to the various frameworks such as STUTS, Hibernate, EJB, JSF, etc. The Spring frameworks comprises the several modules such as IOC, AOP, DAO, Context, ORM, Web MVC, etc. Okay. So guys, the second question you may get asked is, like, explain Spring architecture. Spring framework provide a number of features for an enterprise application. However, it does not enforce the developer to integrate their application with a complete framework. The various features provided by the Spring frameworks are categorized into seven different modules. The developers may choose to integrate their application with one or more Spring modules depending upon the features they wanted to use in their application. So guys, the Spring framework architecture contains the seven different modules, and they are like AOP, ORM, DAO, Web Context, MVC, and the core module, right? So guys, the next question you may get, like, what is a core container of a Spring framework? The core container is the heart of a Spring framework, and all other modules are built on top of it. It provides the dependency injection features, such also known as the inversion of control, right? These module contain the bean factory and implementation of the factory pattern, which creates and manages the life cycle of a various application object known as beans, defined in a Spring bean configuration file. So fourth question you may get, like, is what is the application context? Application context is a module. This module provides the various enterprise level services like the internalization, okay, internationalization, I-118, and the JNDI access email, etc. Okay, what is AOP in Spring? This module help in implementing the various cross-cutting concern in the application, like logging, transaction management, etc. This concern are the decoupled from the application code and are injected into the various point code through the configuration file. So guys, what is a Spring Wave? Spring framework help in developing a web-based application by providing the Spring Wave module. This module is built on the top of the application context module and provides web-oriented features. So guys, the next question is the important question, like, what is a Spring MVC? Spring MVC module is built on the top of the Spring Wave module and help in developing a web application based on MVC design pattern, right? So the next question you may get, like, what is a Spring DAO, that is DAO? Almost every enterprise application need to interact with the database, right? Spring DAO module make it easy to interact with the database by providing an abstraction over a low-level JDBC tasks, like creating a database connection and, like, releasing to a database, etc. Okay, so guys, what is Spring ORM? There exist a number of popular object relational mapping tools like Hibernate, IBTs and the JPA, etc. Spring ORM module help in interacting with these tools. So guys, the next question is like, what is a Spring Bean? Every classes you are writing in a Spring application can be called as a Spring Bean. It can be a Pojo Java class, or any classes you are writing in a Spring application can be called as a Spring Bean. So guys, the next important question is like, what are the advantages of the Spring framework and what are the disadvantages of the Spring framework? So guys, we are going to see the advantages of the Spring frameworks are like, the Spring framework is a lightweight in nature due to it the Pojo implementation, which does not force us to inherit any classes or implement any interfaces, right? The second advantage of the Spring framework is like, it support other frameworks and it integration make Spring easier to develop. The third advantage of the Spring framework is like, the Spring application is loosely coupled due to the dependency injection. The fourth is, it is easier to test and it does not require any server to run the application. The fifth advantage is like, it provide a powerful abstraction to a Java EE specifications like JDBC, JTA, etc. So guys, what are the disadvantages of a Spring framework? The learning curve of a Spring framework is very high, as most developers find it hard to understand and apply. The second disadvantage is like, the nature of the Spring framework keeps on changing over a course of time, which make it harder to grasp. For example, the annotation-based Spring is not everybody cup of tea. The third disadvantage is like, for many, it is time-consuming process, as the Spring framework has to lot of integration with another frameworks, due to which it is hard to know all the options that are available in a Spring framework. Okay. So guys, the next questions you may get like, what is a Spring IOC, inversion of control? When you are developing any component or a bean in a Spring, it may contain some dependencies. Those bean dependencies can be initialized into two ways, and the two ways are like, first create the object and initialize, and second will be like, look up the registry and initialize. With Spring IOC or DI, dependency injection, Spring container is responsible for initializing or injecting the bean dependencies automatically, right? So the next question you may get like, what are the three ways of the Spring dependency injections uses to inject the dependencies? And guys, this is the important question. Okay, so guys, Spring dependency injection uses the three ways to inject the dependencies. First is the setter injection, second is the constructor injection, and third is the field injection. So guys, the field injection is done by using annotation, right? So guys, what is dependency? Any property available in a bean class or a Java class which need to be initialized is called as dependency. So guys, the property of a bean class in a Spring are known as the dependencies. Then the next question arises is like, what is the injection? So guys, the injection is the initialization of a bean class property is called as injection. So guys, the initialization of a bean class property is called as injection, right? So guys, the next question is like, what is dependency injection, DI? The process of initializing the bean dependency is called as the dependency injection. So actually, the dependency injection is the process of initializing bean dependencies is called as dependency injection. Then what is a setter injection? So guys, the process of initializing the bean dependencies with the help of the setter method is called as setter injection. So next question is like, how can I implement setter injection? By using the property tag, you can implement setter injection. The next question is like, what is a constructor injection? The process of initializing the bean dependencies with a constructor is called as the constructor injection. The injection are done by the constructor is known as the constructor injection. How can I implement constructor injection? By using construct arg tag, right? What is bean definition then? The configuring the bean and its dependencies in a Spring configuration document is called as the bean definition. Okay. So guys, when should I use property tag and the constructor arg tag? The property tag is used for the setter injection and the constructor tag is used for the constructor injection, right? So the next two questions we will discuss in this part will be like, when should you use value attribute and the reference attribute? Use value attribute for specifying the values for simple type variables like primitive variables, wrapper variables and string variables. Use of the reference attribute for specifying bin references for references type variables. Okay, so guys, the last questions of this session is like, what are the GOF, the gang of four pattern used in a Spring IOC container? So guys, the pattern used in a Spring IOC container will be singleton pattern and a factory pattern. Okay guys, so guys, these are the questions asked in an interview of a Spring. Okay, so guys, thank you, stay connected, see you in the next session. Till then, thank you, bye bye, and all the best for your interview.